We're building lots of relationships with people. They get to come out here and experience this with us, right? And so, like, part of keeping it alive, like, we're keeping it alive. And so part of keeping it alive is sharing it with other people. It's part of reconciliation. So it's about, like, creating new history. So we have the old history that people don't like to acknowledge or talk about, or it's uncomfortable for people. And so this is a way we can all do something together and make a new history for us. It's nice to be able to connect people to their food. I think when people come out and they get to dance on the rice, it does make them happier. It gives me hope that people want to come here, or that they want to learn about their food. People get to come and learn about how we ate and learn about who we are. And it's not an intimidating environment for people to enter. You think everyone's welcome and feels welcome. And so we're connecting to people that we might not have otherwise, like people that don't rice in their life. It's nice for me to do it myself because it gives me a sense of identity and connects me to my past. Like, I think it is about keeping it alive. Like, it's not about the business, it's about the practice, and that's the farming of it, right, is the act. So going out and doing it, and over and over and over, season after season, you know? And it's a grind, like, you have to want to do it. And it feels good to do, like, physically and mentally and emotionally. It's rewarding to know how to provide yourself with food or help other people.
All this darker stuff in here?
Oh, yeah. That's the inside part?
That's the inside.
It feeds me. The groups of people that we educate help change up our season too, right? It becomes a more social thing like that. Like, it was supposed to be a social thing. And so having the education tours be a part of it helped give it that community feel while we grind it out.
Okay. One, two, three.
Good catch, you've done great.